This is Pratima from Planet Physiology. In this video, we shall learn about physiology of aging. This topic is dealt under the following headings: Introduction, Importance of the knowledge about aging, Theories of aging, Effects of aging, and How to slow down the pace of aging. According to Collins English Dictionary, aging means growing old, deterioration, senescence, maturation. It is an inevitable process natural to all the living organisms which are reproducing by sexual means. The species like Hydra, which reproduce by binary fission, are said to be immortal. But why sexually reproducing animals have to undergo aging process? We will come to know that little later. Basically, aging is multifactorial process and it can be defined as impaired ability to maintain homeostasis in response to external or internal stress. So, at what age this impairment occurs, or what is the age of aging? When we say a particular person is, say, 40 years old or 70 years old, we are talking about the chronological age, which may or may not be same as that of biological age of a person. Let us understand with the example. Here is a famous model, actor, and international swimmer, Milind Soman. He has been redefining fitness at 50 in India. How? He finished Ironman challenge in 15 hours and 19 minutes in his first attempt at the age of 50. And the force behind his success was his mother, performing push-ups, running marathon at her age, and that too in sari and barefoot, leaves us awestruck. And hence, we can say that biological age and chronological age do not match. Knowing physiology of aging helps us to understand concept of primary aging, which is normal aging process, secondary aging, where there is susceptibility to various age-related diseases like cancer, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, Alzheimer's, dementia, and so on. It also helps to understand the concept of psychological aging as well as successful aging. This knowledge is also helpful to differentiate physiological as well as pathological phenomena in geriatric population and to appreciate impact of normal age-related degeneration on diseases and their management. This gerontology is such a vast science that medicine has a separate branch for it called as geriatric medicine. Now you may get a question that why do we age and how do we age? And to answer this query, many scientists have put forth various theories of aging. All these theories can be grouped into two categories: the program theories, are also called as genetic theories, and damage theories. These programmed theories or genetic theories are based on concept of apoptosis, and according to these theories, aging follows biological timetable due to changes in genetic expressions, and the time of aging and death is predetermined at the time of birth itself. In contrast, damage theories emphasize role of environmental assaults to cells and cumulative damage at various levels cause aging. But no single theory can explain the concept of aging. In next few slides, we shall see some important theories. Starting with genetic theories, first we shall study programmed longevity theory. According to this theory, aging results due to switching on and off of certain genes, and the time when age-associated deficits are manifested is called as senescence. The next important theory is telomere theory, where length of telomere decides life of a cell. This is very important concept, and hence we shall study it in detail. Telomere is a Greek word where telos means end and mere means part. It is the region of repetitive nucleotide sequence at each end of the chromosome. It protects chromosomal ends from deterioration and their fusion with neighboring chromosomes. It was discovered by American cytogeneticist Barbara McClintock And for this work, she received Nobel Prize in 1983. Now let us understand this theory. In 1961, Leonard Hayflick studied human skin cells in a laboratory and observed that cells can divide only up to 50 times and then become senescent. But he could not explain the mechanism behind it. And now this concept was proven true and it is known as Hayflick's limit. A decade later, Olonikon hypothesized that telomere length shortens with every cell division and at certain length of telomere, cells lose their division capacity and become senescent. Again, almost after a decade of this hypothesis, Greeder and Blackburn discovered the enzyme telomerase, which replaces DNA sequence in telomere that is lost during cell division. And for this work, they received Nobel Prize in 2009. It was found that this enzyme is active only in germ cells, stem cells and certain WBCs and hence they can divide indefinitely. The length of telomere varies from species to species and in human being, telomere is made up of about 2500 repetitions of the base pair and there are about 11 kilobases at birth which reduces to less than 4 kilobases in old age. According to Hayflick's limit, humans have maximum lifespan of 115 years but all do not live till this age because the telomeres are highly susceptible for oxidative stress. Also, many diseases like depression, insulin resistance, osteoporosis shorten telomere and reduce the lifespan of the cell. Still, it is not clear whether short telomeres is a sign of aging or it contributes to aging. Currently, a lot of research is going on this topic. Coming to the next genetic theory, endocrine theory. It states that biological clock acts through hormones to control pace of aging. And it may be due to loss of hypothalamic precision in regulation of release of various hormones and also decreased sensitivity of hormone receptors. It may be due to atrophy of thymus gland. The third theory is immunological theory, which assumes that immune system is programmed to decline over the period of time and it increases vulnerability of the body to various infectious diseases leading to aging and death. Now let us see some random damage theories. First is wear and tear theory. According to this theory, there is progressive damage to the cells and body systems over a period of time. It means like any machine, our body also wears out due to repeated use and loses its proper functionality leading to aging. The next is rate of basal metabolism theory. It states that more the basal oxygen consumption rate, shorter is the lifespan. And this theory can explain why the hibernating animals have greater lifespan. Also, it has been found that the yogis who perform regular meditation also have prolonged lifespan. It may be explained based on this theory. The third theory under random damage theories is cross-linkage theory or glycosylation theory. According to this theory, glucose combines with proteins in presence of oxygen and causes protein impairment by establishing cross-linking. Accumulation of such cross-linked proteins cause damage to the cells and tissues and slow down the various bodily processes leading to aging. Next is free radical theory by Harman. According to this theory, free radicals damage macromolecular components in the cells and accumulation of these damages stops cells from functioning, leading to aging. Now it is also proved that free radicals also damage DNAs and shorten telomeres, leading to aging. As this is also an important topic, we shall study this in a bit detail. Free radicals are reactive oxygen species which have unpaired electrons in their outer orbit. This creates extra negative charge and makes them more reactive. To stabilize themselves, they react with healthy molecules and in turn convert these healthy molecules into reactive oxygen species. Now these molecules react with other healthy molecules, converting them into ROS. Thus, they set up chain reaction. Variety of reactive oxygen species are generated in our body. For example, superoxide anions, hydrogen peroxide, hydroxyl ion, nitric oxide radical, peroxynitrite radical. Actually, hydrogen peroxide itself is not a free radical, but it is highly reactive molecule and therefore it is included in this list. Optimum generation of this reactive oxygen species is helpful to our body, but excess can cause damage to the cell membrane lipids, proteins and other macromolecules. To keep them in check, we also have antioxidants in our body which scavenge free radicals. Antioxidants can be enzymatic like superoxide dismutase, glutathione peroxidase or catalase, or they could be non-enzymatic like ascorbic acid, which is vitamin C, alpha tocopherol, flavonoids or phenolic acids. Some of these are water soluble and some are lipid soluble. Some are predominant in intracellular compartments and others act extracellularly. Thus, they can scavenge free radicals in various mediums and help protect our cells. In health, always a balance between free radical and antioxidants is maintained, and imbalance leads to oxidative stress and accelerate aging. Next theory is calorie intake theory. Cell signals indicating excess calorie promote cell division, whereas signals indicating lack of calorie indicate cellular stress and cells are directed to promote repair processes. Few other important theories we shall study briefly. First is disengagement theory. According to this theory, if the relationship between a person and other members of the society are severed and altered in quality, it leads to social withdrawal and accelerate aging. Activity theory describes psychological aging process and emphasizes importance of ongoing social activity. Active involvement in family or recreational activities can prevent or delay aging. Membrane theory states that there is decrease in membrane lipids with aging. It causes impaired efficiency of membrane to perform normal functions and it cannot transfer chemicals, heat or impulses properly. This leads to accumulation of toxins and promotes aging. According to mitochondrial decline theory, there is decrease in number of mitochondria with aging and it is responsible for cellular death. So these were various theories which tried to explain mechanism of aging. Whatever is the process, what are the manifestations of aging? As indicated in this graph, with advancing age, there is decrease in BMR, maximal heart rate, muscle strength, bone density, maximal cardiac output, vital capacity and VO2 max. And there is increase in blood pressure and body weight. This graph indicates change in the organ function with advancing age. Blue line indicates resting level of organ function and red indicates maximum percentage of organ function that can be achieved if required. The difference between two lines is functional reserve available. With advancing age, there is slight decline in basal level of organ functions, but after the age of 60 years, maximum functioning that can be achieved is reduced drastically. In simple words, with advancing age, functional reserve decreases. Let us see important changes seen in old age, starting with cardiovascular system. With advancing age, there is decrease in the basal heart rate due to decrease in the pacemaker cells in SA node, decreased cardiac reserve and beta receptor sensitivity. Also, there is decreased baroreceptor responsiveness, which can explain orthostatic hypotension in elderly population. With advancing age, there is systolic hypertension, and this is mainly due to increased arterial stiffness. The sustained increase in afterload causes left ventricular hypertrophy. Let us see effects seen in the respiratory system. There is ventilation perfusion mismatch, decreased sensitivity to carbon dioxide, decrease in chest wall compliance but increase in lung compliance. Various lung volume capacities show changes, like there is increase in residual volume, functional residual capacity as well as closing volume, but decrease in vital capacity. various protective reflexes also decrease. For example, cuff reflex. Cilia also lose effectiveness over the period of time, and this makes elderly population prone to pneumonia. Musculoskeletal system shows sarcopenia. As you can see in this picture, the cross-section of the muscles seen in 31-year-old person and 85-year-old person. There is decrease in the number of muscle fibers, and as well as existing muscle fibers show atrophy. And these changes are predominantly seen in sedentary individuals. As a result, there is decrease in the muscle strength. Osteoporotic changes are seen in the bones, which increases risk of fractures, and also there is decrease in the bone mineral density. Nervous system shows varied changes. The important one I have enumerated here. Similar to muscles, there is neuronal atrophy also, which can manifest in various signs and symptoms. There is decreased secretion of neurotransmitters and number of neurotransmitter receptors. There is reduction in the amount of deep sleep and impairment in the recent memory. Body temperature shows greater variability in core temperature, and there is more risk of hypothermia in elderly population. And this is mainly due to attenuated vasoconstrictor response to the cold. Also, there is increased threshold for sweating. Other effects include change in body composition. There is increase in the fat and decrease in the total body water in elderly population. Also, there is arthritis, menopause or andropause. Immunity is compromised. Various organ functions are declined, especially liver function and hepatic blood flow is decreased, and number of nephrons as well as renal functions are decreased. Based on this knowledge, we can say that aging is unavoidable but can be slowed down. So, few tips to slow down this aging and increase the lifespan with better quality of life are here. First is calorie restriction by 30%. But at the same time, diet should have proper vitamins and antioxidants. This calorie restriction with vitamin supplements and antioxidant supplements increase the average life expectancy, delays age-associated diseases, there is less deterioration of various physiological processes, and it also influences gene expression, protein turnover, as well as cross-linking. Physically active lifestyle, performing some resistance training, active involvement in family or social and recreational activities will definitely slow the pace of aging. Freedom from diseases and disability, maintaining high cognitive as well as physical functioning, and active engagement with the life will lead to successful aging. Till now, we have studied about normal aging process. There are certain diseases associated with accelerated aging process. These are collectively called as progeria. Amongst progeria syndromes, most common is Hutchinson-Gilford progeria syndrome. Others include Werner syndrome and Cochlearn syndrome. Progeria is extremely rare autosomal dominant disorder. It is caused due to point mutation in LMNA gene, and this causes defective production of lamin A protein, which is associated with nuclear membrane. This defective protein is also called as progerin, which is also expressed in normal senescent cells. It leads to defect in nuclear membrane and makes cell division difficult. It is also associated with defects in DNA repair mechanism as well as increase in genomic instability, leading to accelerated aging. Currently, only symptomatic treatment is available for this condition. The patient shows 8 to 10 times faster than normal aging process, and usually symptoms develop in first few months of life. In this patient, mental as well as motor development is normal, but all other processes are accelerated, and average lifespan of patient is about 13 years. So this is all about the physiology of aging. Thank you. If you enjoy my sessions, press the like button and share it with your friends. If you haven't yet subscribed my channel, press the subscribe button. To get notifications about new releases, press bell icon. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.